Now we'll look at some examples of factoring and solving quadratic equations in the form x squared plus bx plus c equals 0. Notice how the leading coefficient is equal to 1. Our first equation, we have x squared plus 4x minus 21 equals 0. So if this trinomial factors, it will factor into two binomial factors where the terms in the first positions will come from the factors of x squared, which would be x and x. And the terms in the second positions will be the factors of c that add to b, or in this case, the factors of negative 21 that add to positive 4. Let's list all the factors of negative 21. We could have negative 1 times 21, or negative 21 times 1, or negative 3 times 7, or negative 7 times 3. We want the two factors that have a sum of positive 4, which means the winning factors will be negative 3 and positive 7. Therefore, one of the binomial factors will be x minus 3, and the other factor will be x plus 7. Because the 3 is negative, we have minus 3. Because the 7 is positive, we have plus 7. Of course, if we put the plus 7 here and the minus 3 here, it's not going to change our solutions. So now we have the trinomial in factored form where this product is equal to 0. We can use the zero product property to solve this equation. Again, if this product is equal to 0, either the first factor of x minus 3 must equal 0, or the second factor of x plus 7 must equal 0. And now we'll solve each of these equations for x. So here we would add 3 to both sides. So we'd have x equals 3. Or here we would subtract 7 on both sides. So we'd have x equals negative 7. These are the two solutions to our quadratic equation. Let's take a look at a second example. Again, if this does factor, it'll factor into two binomial factors where the terms in the first positions will be the factors of x squared, which will be x and x. And then the terms in the second positions will be the factors of negative 27 that add to negative 6. So let's go ahead and list the factors of negative 27. We could have negative 3 times 9, negative 9 times 3, negative 1 times 27, and negative 27 times 1. Of course, if we can visualize these in our mind, we don't have to list them, but now we want the two factors that have a sum of negative 6, which would be negative 9 and positive 3, which means one factor will be x minus 9, and one factor will be x plus 3. And now that it's in factored form, and we have our product equal to 0, either the first factor of x minus 9 must equal 0, or the factor of x plus 3 must equal 0. And now we'll solve these two equations for x to determine our solutions. So here we would add 9 to both sides. We'd have x equals 9, or here we would subtract 3 on both sides. So we'd have x equals negative 3. Again, these are the two solutions to our quadratic equation. Okay, we'll look at some more examples in the next video.